The beginning of this church occurred in 1940. And if you remember 1940, you wouldn't remember it, but if you study your history of 1940, you'll know what was going on. World War II had just started in the previous fall. The Battle of Britain was happening. Dunkirk was happening. France had fallen. Britain was facing imminent invasion. And it was a very, very serious time in the world. And so this group of people in Owosso, a little backwater town of 200 to 300 people, it was 4 blocks long and about 2 blocks wide, they felt an urgency to meet. And this is how Owosso First Assembly was formed back in those days. They met in an ex-grocery store. They met at the Masonic Lodge. In 43, they bought some land and built a little block building where the old church is on Main Street. The first official pastor, a lady by the name of Lela McGuire. She was pastor from January of 44 to November. Brother George Shom and his family came January of 45. Shortly thereafter, I came into the world, and my great-grandmother and my grandmother and her sister and her brother, we showed up and came to Owosso from the Collinsville Church. Brother Shom was here for 10 years. Brother Burns came after him, and shortly thereafter, in 59, Brother Tomlinson came and started building the new church, the one that's on Main Street now. We did not have indoor bathrooms at Owosso First Assembly until about 1960. It's hard to believe, but...
Well, we moved from Coffeyville, Kansas, here. We were welcomed. Brother Tomlinson and Sister Tomlinson were just so special to us, and they welcomed us in, and immediately I began teaching. Brother Tomlinson was needing teachers, so at the ripe age of 15, I started teaching Sunday school and then worked in children's church. My mother, Margaret Kramer, and my dad, Merrill, they worked with the children, and my mom taught me many things on how to work with children, skits, drama, and I still do it today in my class. I enjoy it so much. One of the most exciting things in my life was when I met my husband, Larry. And my brother and sister, David and Jane, they both met their spouses in this little church of Owosso. We were married by Brother Tomlinson, and we had these two boys, and they were dedicated by Brother Tomlinson, as well as the other 7 grandchildren of my mom. Our life was centered around Owosso First Assembly. We went to revivals. These boys were up with us late at night, and didn't matter, it was family. We were church, and we just enjoyed it so much. My mother and father taught me how to pray, how to believe, how to trust God in all circumstances. We went through some rough waters for a while when my father passed away, but God has been faithful. He sent people along our lives to help us along those difficult journeys. The church family is our family, and these boys have been prayed over by grandparents. When the boys were sick, we knew that we would call the church, they would be prayed for, and they were healed. And then the boys received the Holy Spirit of speaking in tongues. Those are precious memories for me. Now I'll let the boys have a turn.
We warned them not to embarrass the family or anything like that.
Well, we were up at the church all the time growing up. My dad was the Sunday school superintendent, and we had, I don't know how long, but like 100-foot-long banana split contest, and it just changed my life, this church. It was always, we were here every time the doors were open. We drove from Broken Arrow for 26 years, 30 or 45 minutes each way to church, but that didn't stop us. We were here all the time. I remember those teacher meetings, we would go up into the supply room and we'd make all kinds of stuff out of construction paper, and then Curtis decided to go crawl through the attic, and I had to follow him, of course. It was his idea, but
I didn't know about that recently. I had a lot of memories. Most of them probably, Philip seemed to get in trouble the most here at church. I think most people probably realize that, but some of my fondest memories, obviously, I met my wife, Lindsay, and she likes to tell people how blessed I am that she came into my life. But really, being under Pastor Kevin's leadership, going through the youth group, I pretty much lived up here. And probably of all the favorite memories is we would always have dinners at Grandma Jay's house. And every Sunday, no matter what, it was pretty much a full Thanksgiving dinner. And she would just allow us to bring anybody we wanted. I had half the kids in youth group would always come over, and she just absolutely loved it.
Well, like Curtis said, he met Lindsay here, I met Rachel. All of our children have been dedicated. They love Sunday school. So it's been a family affair for many, many years.
It's amazing to me to look back that my grandchildren can look back and see their great, great, great grandmother was a member of this church at age 75 when it started, and she lived to be 87, so she was a member 12 years before she passed away. But all that said, the important thing is they're a member of the family of God. Whether you've been here 6 months, whether you've been here seven decades or whatever, that's the important part. They're a member of the family of God. It's
well,
just amazing.
I'll add that, you know, the spiritual heritage I have through my family, well, it's not just limited to my family, it's this church and the church family. I remember all those saints, Sister Tate and the others that have gone on, but who were prayer warriors. They invested in my life, in Curtis's life, in our lives. And we have that legacy, that heritage, and we celebrate that with the 75th anniversary of our church.